in some ways you could say it started back in undergrad when I decided I wanted to be a double major in chemistry and art, because it was actually the art stuff that brought me to chess. But it was through one of those art history classes that I met Arthur. So Arthur was one of the instructors of a class called Art Science Intersections, where a couple of paintings came here to chess to do X-ray fluorescence mapping. They knew there were some hidden compositions underneath at least one of them, and so that's what we were investigating. And I was able to actually kind of process the data on my own as it was rolling in, as we were watching these paintings slowly being unveiled. It was completely amazing. That was just like one evening of art exploration here at chess that really got me hooked. It was the art world that got me here, which is probably not a typical path for synchrotron scientists. But now that I'm here and I see all the different applications that X-ray fluorescence has, it's really inspiring. It's a lot of fun to work with all the people from so many different fields. Shortly, I will be going to the Met, the Metropolitan Museum of Art, to take on a Mellon Conservation Fellowship in their scientific research department. So for my own research, I got really interested in studying the illuminated manuscripts in the library's collection, and I don't know if that's something I'll get to do there. They've collected a lot of data, and I think one thing I'll be working on is streamlining their data analysis process, kind of bringing some of the tools that I use here at chess to their work. That's the hope. If you told me 2 years ago that I would be going to the Met to work behind the scenes on X-ray science, I would have thought you were crazy.